We have carried the day.
Hi there, little one.
We're just off to hunt down the horrible, nasty monster who's been kidnapping people from the village.
Is your father named Dar, by any chance? So you were not abducted? And what are you doing in such a dangerous place? Your father is worried about you.
My father does not care for me. He cares for my mother's necklace more than anything else. He told the monster so. I thought he would say I was the most precious thing to him. It made me very sad. So I decided to follow the monster and get the necklace back for him. Then he will see that I'm worth something. But then I strayed too far from the village and became scared. So I stopped here to hide.
What your father said was upsetting, I am sure. But this is no place for a child. Come, we will return you to the village.
No! If you are going after the monster, I am coming with you. I have to get my mother's necklace back!
Oh, don't be such a spoilsport, Hendrik! We'll look after the little darling. And besides, he'll be safer with us than out here on his own.
Very well. But the boy is your responsibility.
Thank you! Thank you! I will be useful to you, I promise. The monster went that way. There is a cave on the cape where she is hiding.
You heard him, everybody! Let's go teach that dirty bandit a lesson!
Surprise! Not many humans wander in here of their own accord.
Avarice, you fiend! You are going to give back what you've taken and let all the people of the village go. And you are going to do it now.
So that is why you are here! You humans and your heroic nonsense! Still, I suppose you have shown a lot of courage coming here. Very well. Let's say I do give everything back. It's not going to happen for free. You're going to have to give me something to sweeten the deal. How about your most valued possession? That seems like a fair trade, wouldn't you say?
Wait! If you wish to make a deal, fiend, you must make it with me. I have something for you. Something soft and warm. And fragrant. Something I just know you are going to love.
Ooh, what is it? What is it? It sounds amazing! I have to see it right now! Hand it over! Hand it over!
With pleasure! I do hope it brings you joy.
Let me see! Let me see! Ugh! What is that awful smell? You! Do you think this is some kind of joke?
Oh, don't you like it, honey? I chose it especially for you.
You'll pay for this! Avarice will not be mocked by a silly, dumb-tub little human! Maybe this will teach you a lesson! Don't bother begging for mercy! Your lives are mine now! And I'm not giving them back!
Safe hands.
You are so sleepy.
Huh.
That's what you get for being a nasty, greedy girl.
Everybody, are you okay? You are not hurt.
We are fine, thanks to you. Our brave little son. Avarith only kept us prisoner. She did not hurt us.
You saved us. I do not know how to thank you.
Fair maiden, a smile will more than suffice.
Here it is! My mother's necklace! Oh, but... It is broken. I cannot take this back to my father. It will only make him more sad.
Oh, of course it won't, you silly boy. Did not Daddy ever tell you it's the thought that counts? It could be smashed to pieces and you'd still be his little hero. All right, time to take Son and the others back to the village in style. Come, darlings, your parade awaits! You take your time, honey. We'll be having all kinds of fun. Ciao for now!
Thank you. than ever!
We have carried the day.
At all.
Hello, Father. I brought Mother's necklace back from the lair of the beast for you. But it is broken.
You did what? Foolish child! You could have been killed. And then where would I be, without you, my most treasured possession?
But you said that Mother's necklace was your most treasured possession.
I said it, but I did not mean it. How could I? Don't you see? I did not trust the monster, so I said a lie. I lied because I wanted to protect you.
Really? I thought you did not care about me. I am so sorry. You must have been so worried.
To think it was all but a misunderstanding. If only he and his father had simply been honest with one another.
Yes, if only. I'll see you both outside, okay?
Ah, Father, these are my new friends. They are the ones who rescued everybody.
Oh. I cannot thank you enough. You are true heroes. Last time we met, when you rescued me, I was searching for Son. But I had to pretend that I did not care, in case the monster came back and realized that I had lied. I hope you understand.
Where is my friend with the feathers? I wanted to say thank you.
Silvando left Frey suddenly. Perhaps we should go and look for him.
He and his father had simply been honest with one another.
Ah, you scared me! How long have you been standing there? Ah, never mind. It was nice to see Son reunited with his father, huh? But there are some who will never be reunited with their loved ones. Some bridges that will never be repaired. Can I ask you something? Morthagon he's super powerful, right? Powerful enough to destroy our world. You've seen that power for yourself, but you still want to fight him, don't you? You really are a hero, huh? You know, I thought it was enough, traveling the world, trying to put smiles back on people's faces. But what good is a smile here and there if the Lord of Shadows could snatch it away at any moment? What I'm saying is, I have to leave my beloved parade and come with you. It's the only way. But there's something I want you to help me with first. It's all well and good me going and getting my head squished by Mordegon, but I can't do that to my darling boys. So we have to leave them somewhere safe, with somebody who can look after them. Now, I know just the place and just the person, but... Well, there's no good way of saying this. I'm petrified of seeing him. So you have to come with me. You will, won't you, darling? Oh, thank you. I knew you'd say yes. Okay, I'm going to go break the news to my little soldiers of Smile. Meet me outside the village, all right? I have an announcement to make. My parading days are over.
No!
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 But do not fear. It will only be for a little while. I will return as soon as the Lord of Shadows is defeated.
We understand, Sylve. That Mordegon's stolen enough smiles. Someone's got to stop him.
Yeah, you go and do what you gotta do, Sylve. We'll be heartbroken without you, of course, but we'll survive. And if anyone can show that rotten spoilsport what's what, it's you.
Exactly. We'll never get those smiles back if I don't do this. And I won't be leaving you high and dry. I'm going to ask my papi to look after you in Puerto Valor.
Puerto Valor? Wait. Surely not. Surely you cannot be Don Rodrigo's...
So you finally figured it out, huh? Same old stone-headed Hendrik. Such a sweet, simple boy.
Ah! All right, my little champions of cheer. Let's go show Puerto Valor how to pop!
I cannot fathom it. The boy is unrecognizable, and he has abandoned the name his father gave him. Don Rodrigo must be furious. For
Forgive me for my lack of composure. This has all come as quite a shock. Silvando is none other than the son and heir of Don Rodrigo, the noblest and most revered of all knights. It was always assumed that he would follow in his father's footsteps. But the two had a terrible argument, and the boy left Puerto Valor, never to return. Until now. But perhaps this is not such a bad thing. I have been meaning to visit Don Rodrigo and seek his counsel. Very well. It is not far from here to Puerto Valor. The road will take us north, then east. Come, let us follow the parade. Diligence is its own reward.
Might as well share the wealth.
Accept your fate. Darkness, hear me. All is well that ends well. Victory will be ours! accept your fate. Carried the day.
Another day, another victory. We have carried the day.
Thank you.
so strange. I thought I'd never see this place again, and yet here I am. Well, at least I came back with a bang. You go on ahead, honey. I need a second to compose myself.
Don Rodrigo, it is I, Hendrik. It has been too long.
Hendrik? How many years has it been since you completed your training, eh? Come closer, caballero. Let me see your face. I have heard many tales of your exploits. To think that the great lump of meat who came to me all those years ago is now the hero of Eleador.
I had not expected to find you in such good spirits, my lord. As one who owes everything to your kind offices, it pleases me greatly. Alas, there has been precious little cause for mirth since last we met. Dundrasil fell, then Yggdrasil, and now the Lord of Shadows roams the land. Don Rodrigo and I have much to discuss. Perhaps you could go and fetch Silvando while we talk.
Hey, honey. I guess they sent you to fetch me, huh? It's so silly, I know. Here I am, happy to go put my neck on the line in the fight against the Lord of Shadows. And yet, the thought of facing Papi makes me want to run away screaming. Seeing that boy and his father in Phnomnon made me think I could do it. That I could finally face him. But now I'm here, I'm so scared. You've heard what happened with me and him, I guess. Hendrik told you, huh? It all seems so far away now. Even before I could walk, I was training to be a knight, you know? I would stay in Puerto Valor and follow in my father's footsteps. Then one day, the circus came to town. It was so, so fabulous. I can't even describe it. It was love at first sight. I knew from the second I walked into that tent that I'd found my calling. Getting up on that stage and making people happy, that was the life for me. But Papi, he wasn't so keen. A few plates got smashed the night I broke the news to him, let me tell you. But I wasn't going to let that stop me. Oh no. This was my calling. To make the whole world happy. I would be a knight in smiling armor. He didn't have anything to say to me after that. That was when I knew that I had to go and prove to him that I meant what I said. So I left. And I haven't seen him since. Ah, dear me, that got a bit long and emotional, huh? But it's made me feel a whole lot better. In fact, yes, let's do this. It's now or never. Let's go pay Papi a visit.
Thank you.
Hi, puppy.
Caramba. Norberto, you dare to show your face in my presence. And you have come to tell me something, see?
I'm sorry, puppy. Sorry. So sorry.
Sorry? What are you apologizing for, foolish boy?
Huh?
You have succeeded in making the world smile, see?
Not yet, puppy.
Then why are you here, hmm? Why did you come back if you have not yet done as you promised? You said you would do it, Norberto. You said you would make everyone happy. I did not raise you to be a failure. How dare you come to me and...
Puppy!
Damn you, boy. If I were younger, I would put you over my knee. What kind of a knight makes an oath and does not fulfill it?
Wait. Puppy, did you say knight? You still think of me as one? Oh, you have no idea how... Oh, thank you, puppy. Thank you. I guess it wasn't very knightly of me to come back before I'd fulfilled my promise, huh? But I had a good reason.
The Lord of Shadows. See?
See. How can I make people happy if he is there making their lives miserable? It is impossible. Which is why I'm going to beat him. Only then can I fulfill my vow and make all the people of the world smile again.
Careful, boy! Do not promise to defeat Mordegon if you do not truly intend to do so. I will not have you break another oath.
Of course, Papi. A knight's word is his bond. You taught me that. But there's just one teensy-weensy little thing I need to ask you to do to help. I've picked up a few friends on my travels. They're kind of young and kind of innocent. They need a role model, you know? Someone to lead them.
You do not even need to ask, Norberto. A knight serves the weak untiringly. Or have you forgotten the pledge?
Oh, Papi, really?
Come on, Norberto. Of course, it will be my pleasure.
Oh, aren't you just the sweetest, kindest father a boy could hope to have? Mm-hmm. Oh, darlings! Come...
What a lovely bedroom. Oh, don't tell me this is your dad, Sylph. He's awfully manly. I'll feel safe with you looking after me, Mr. Rodrigo.
Roberto, explain yourself. What is the meaning of this?
Mm-hmm.
let's just pop this on.
Oh. Hey, Norberto, where are you?
Hey!
That's your foolishness, boy! I did not agree to this!
Oh, don't be like that, Papi! How can you lead my little band of boys if you don't... And didn't you always teach me that a knight's word is his... Listen to me, soldiers of Smile. You serve my papi now. You must do as he says. Do not fail me.
Please, Sylv, don't go. Don't leave us.
Darlings, it breaks my heart to say goodbye. Truly, it does. But we have to be strong. As soon as Mordegon is defeated, I'll be right back with you. I'll be home before you know it, you'll see. And no matter how far I go, no matter how hard it gets, I'll always be with you. Always.
Oh, Sylv, we'll be with you too. Just say the words and we'll come running.
Thanks so much for all your help, darling. I'm all yours now, I promise. The salty stallion is all yours too, of course. She's anchored off to the east of here.
With a ship at our disposal, other places will be accessible to us. Perhaps now we can seek out your friends in Arborea.
Thank you.
Thank you.